stuff. I mean, it's good. It's nice. I feel like I'm like between two ferns, but not.
We're hoping to get on that level.
That would be nice.
Team one, take one, call me Mark.
Hey, all you Firebase developers. Welcome to another episode of Ask Firebase, the show where we answer your burning Firebase questions. I'm Jen Person, your host, and today my co-host is John Scripp. Thanks so much for coming on the show.
Yeah, not a problem.
So, are you ready to answer some questions about A/B testing?
I am so ready.
All right, then let's dive right in. Can you believe I get paid to do this?
I know, right?
Like, ridiculous. Our next question is from Yarism, who says, is there any way to run multiple tests at the same time? Or am I going about that the right way?
You can definitely run more experiments, or more than one experiment at once. One thing that you kind of want to watch out for is you don't want to target, if it's an RC experiment, you don't want to target the same RC parameters between the experiments. The way that things come through gets a little weird in doing that. And plus, it kind of messes up your whole flow of testing in general, because you're doing multiple tests on the same value. So it doesn't really provide as much use. But say you wanted to test simultaneously some welcome screen and some store within your app or something like that, that's 100% doable. You just target those things, and it should work out of the box.
Yeah, I'm almost wondering if you have some sort of use case where you're saying you want to target the same remote config values, for instance, then go ahead and let me know, because I'm interested in what that scenario is, and maybe we could point you to a better strategy for doing that.
Yep, for sure.
Okay, here we go. The next question comes. See, I don't even have to try to pronounce this one. There are no vowels in that. And I appreciate that, because then I don't have to like butcher it like I usually do. Yeah, KQTR.
Quarter.
Yeah, maybe quarter. KQTR, we're going with that.
Got it.
When A/B testing with remote config, if a new app version uses a new remote config parameter, will older versions automatically be excluded from the results of the experiment because they do not use that parameter in the code?
So short answer is no, unless you are specifically targeting app version within your targeting parameters. The older versions that are not using it will still pull the value and get enrolled, depending on if you have activation events and all that stuff, but they'll pull it, they can potentially get enrolled, they just won't have any use for that value. So if you want this thing, you will want to target app version specifically.
Yeah, that makes sense. So otherwise it seems like your results could be really skewed because you have all these other people using
yep.
an older version and it's not doing the thing that you're expecting it to do.
For sure, yep.
Looks like we got some more.
Great.
Good?
Yeah.
Okay. I am Ronak. See, this is what I'm talking about. I am Ronak.
Hi, Ronak.
I have an A/B testing experiment running with three variants, control, variant A, and variant B, at 33.3% distribution for each. Now I want to stop that experiment and run it again with just two variants, control and variant B. That way they'll have 50% distribution for each. My question is, will the 33.3% of users who got variant B during the first run of the same experiment get a different variant when I run this experiment again?
So yeah, good question. In short, no. When sampling, the populations, you want random sampling. This means that between experiments, there's zero linkage. There is a good chance that a majority of the people in that 33% end up in the 50% afterwards, just because they qualify for whatever you're targeting. But there is no guarantee that it will be the exact same group or that all 33.3% will end up in that 50% afterwards.
Yeah, that totally makes sense, because let's say that one third happened to just really get along with variant B specifically for some reason. If you put the same people in there, you're gonna get a very similar result, which may not reflect the other two thirds of your population that's
using
your application.
Yeah. So Jen, this question is for you.
This comes
from Reston Webb. Do you know how to fix this? No clients were able to be added to your Firebase project for the following reasons. An app with this package name and SHA-1 is already connected to a Google project.
So they deleted the app and project in another account, but it's still giving them this error. And so what I'll do in like answering that is actually ask you a question, which is at what point did you delete that previous app? Because normally it can take even a week or two for that app to be 100% actually deleted, that project to be completely deleted, which is really to your benefit because quite frequently people contact support saying that they didn't actually mean to do that, and we're able to, you know, restore that information. So I would say if it's been within usually a week, but, you know, give it a couple weeks just to be sure, this is possible that it will give you that error. If it's been longer than that and you're certain that you did delete the previous one, then I recommend that you reach out to support because they may have some more insight into it. It's always possible that in the interim someone else made a project with that, or maybe you were just removed from permissions from the previous project potentially. So they can really dig down into what's happening there. But if this is something that you're experiencing, just make sure you wait a couple weeks to be sure that the previous project has actually been completely deleted. John, thanks so much for coming on and answering all of these burning questions about A/B testing. I really appreciate it. And thank all of you who have asked questions and submitted questions. And if you have your own burning question, be sure to put it on social media with the hashtag AskFirebase. And who knows, you might see it on a future episode. Also, if you like what you see here, be sure to subscribe to the Firebase YouTube channel where you'll see all sorts of other interesting content. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you on a future episode.
And I just drank too much coffee.
That's the right mood to be in, though.
It is, but coffee. Yeah, but it dries your mouth out.
Yes. Yeah. All right, here we go.